In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can drive assembly constraints to show motion in Autodesk Inventor assemblies. First, of course, I need some sort of constraint, and as you can see, I have a constraint here that controls this movable jaw, and I can adjust the values, and of course, I can see it change location. I would like to show the animation of this moving back and forth to show the full motion. To do this, I'll locate the constraint in the model browser, right-click on it, and select Drive. Then in the dialog box, I can enter a start value and an end value, then press Play. As you can see, it's going to go all the way from the beginning to end in this animation. We have some additional options down below. We can control how many times this goes back and forth, so I can set it to start, end, start, and put in a larger value, and now you can see that when I click play, it's just going to go back and forth a few times. We can also control the speed at which this moves, so for example, if I were to bump this up to 5 millimeters, you can see it's going to be a much faster animation. And then finally, I can select the record button to export this out to a video file to show the assembly motion. Let's look at a different example, this time with angles. I'm going to add an angular constraint between one of the planes on the spindle and the vise itself here. Then I'll locate that constraint, right click and drive. And then very similar idea here, I can go ahead and enter in a value and press play, and I will see the animation. Of course, if that's going too slow, I can expand the box and bump that up, maybe go 2 degrees each step instead to speed that up. So once again, to drive a constraint, you just simply need a constraint, right click on it and select drive, and then put in the allowable values to see the motion. That concludes this look at driving assembly constraints in Autodesk Inventor.